goodness.
Campbell rolls right, looks for the end zone, fires in the back, touchdown. Oh, he dropped it. Oh, my goodness. In the end zone, Cadillac player. Campbell, touchdown, Auburn. Touchdown, Auburn. And it's intercepted to the Rose Green. Jason Campbell, quick out, thrown, and caught by Taylor in the end zone.
Here to the Home Depot SEC on CBS from the heart of the campus, Auburn University in Auburn, Alabama. One of the great traditions in this school, the Tiger Walk, led by Tommy Tuberville. If you have a Tiger in your tank, it helps if you're being driven by a Cadillac. And one of the traditions unique to this university, the flight of spirit, the bald eagle. A breathtaking way to begin a wonderful afternoon. The SEC on CBS as the Arkansas Razorbacks come to town to tangle with the Tigers. And here comes Auburn. Tommy Tuberville, the head coach. Right behind them, the Razorbacks of Arkansas. They are 3-2 for the year, a tough loss at home to Texas, a tough loss on the road to Florida, but they are a hard-hitting bunch. And good afternoon, everybody. I'm Vern Lundquist, along with Todd Blackledge and Tracy Wolfson. Welcome to the liveliest village on the plain. There's a buzz about this place that hasn't been present in the last 10 years. Auburn 6-0, ranked fourth in the country. But Tommy Tuberville feels that this game is a real litmus team test for his team. He told us yesterday that at the end of this day, he'll know much more about the Auburn Tigers, about the kind of team they are, and perhaps significantly, the kind of team they can become. And Todd Blackledge, they've got a tough task today. What do they have to do to win this?
Well, first of all, defensively for Auburn, they've got to swarm Arkansas quarterback Matt Jones. Because of his speed and elusiveness, he almost always makes the first guy miss. So they got to get a lot of blue shirts around him every time he has the ball in his hands. On offense, Jason Campbell has to stay hot. He's completing 64% of his passes, 10 touchdowns. He'll get opportunities to throw it downfield today. Finally, I think coming into the game, they have an edge in the special teams. They've got to take advantage of that in the ball game today. When you switch gears to Arkansas, first and foremost for Matt Jones and the offense, protect the football. And their two losses, 7 turnovers have hurt them. Defensively, they can't give up the easy gift touchdowns like they did 2 weeks ago against Florida. Make Auburn earn everything. And third, they've got to find a way to get the game to the fourth quarter. They've outscored their opponents 49-7. They feel if they can get it there with a manageable score, anything can happen.
Weather could not be more splendid. 73 degrees, 41% humidity, slight wind out of the west, and the forecast for continued fair skies. Auburn leads this series, 7-5 and 1-tie. 12 of their 13 get-togethers have been since Arkansas joined the SEC in 1992. Last year, a tough loss for the Razorbacks, 10-3. They were undefeated going into this meeting. And, of course, Auburn was a much beleaguered team, having lost their first two games. And this time, this pesky, hard-hitting Arkansas team comes to town to take on a team ranked fourth in the country. David Carlton will kick off. Aroma Shadu and Cadillac Williams are deep. Among the significant wins for this Auburn team this year, a 1-point victory against LSU here, and that most convincing win on the road at Knoxville a couple of weeks ago against Tennessee. Arkansas won the toss, deferred the option to the second half. Here's Carlton's kick. It's a good one. And that will be taken 9 yards deep, and the Auburn Tigers will open after the touchback at their own 20, and we go down to Tracy Wolfson.
Thanks, guys. After Arkansas's loss to Florida 2 weeks ago, defensive coordinator Dave Womack had a heart-to-heart with his squad. He told them that they were not playing what they call code red defense. He expects them week in and week out to be prepared, play hard, go maximum speed, and finish. He said they didn't do that against Florida, and that is one big reason they failed to come away with a win. He told them it is time to step up and start playing code red defense once again. Vern?
Thank you, Tracy. You got a brief glimpse of Dave Womack on the Arkansas sideline. Here's Jason Campbell. Fires at left side. That's complete to Aroma Shadu. A quick pickup of 8 yards out near the 28-yard line. Darius Vinette, number 4, made the stop. Jason Campbell is having a splendid year, Todd.
He really is. I mean, Al Borges is the new offensive coordinator, the fourth offensive coordinator that Jason Campbell has played under, and he is really flourishing in this new system. And one of the things Al Borges is doing is he's giving him a lot of plays to get himself comfortable in the game. That first pass like that, a great way to get your quarterback into a rhythm early.
Backs are in the eye. It's Ronnie Brown as the fullback, and here's Carnell Williams. He's got a first down plus as he is somersaulted at the point of the tackle at the 33-yard line. Randy Kelly, number 6, getting his first start defensively, made the tackle. The ballpark Franks starting lineups, beginning with the offensive line. McNeil, Grubbs, Engel, Danny Lindsay, and Troy Reddick. Up front, Carnell Williams and Ronnie Brown. In the backfield, Aroma Shadu, Anthony Mix, and Cooper Wallace is the tight end. First and 10, Auburn. Now one set back. It's a toss. Here's the reverse. They toss it back to Campbell. He's got Aroma Shadu all by himself. Now the chase is on. And here goes Devin. Aroma Shadu, touchdown, Auburn. 67 yards on the Dipsy Doodle. Cadillac Williams, Courtney Taylor, Jason Campbell, and at the other end, Devin Aroma Shadu.
I talked to Dave Womack before the game. He said, you know, they like to throw a lot of stuff at you early. Formation, shifts. They'll fake a reverse. I even expect to see a reverse in the first series. Didn't expect that.
John Vaughn with the extra point. Devin Aroma Shadu, the senior from Miami, Florida.
Well, take a look at the replay. They show a lot of reverses and fake reverses with this offense. Shifts and movement. Watch the ball handling. It's got to go to Williams, then to Courtney Taylor. Three good exchanges, and Aroma Shadu faked a block. That lured the defense in. And an easy score right away on the first possession for the Auburn Tigers.
7-0. Can you say Aroma Shadu? Took all of 1 minute and 10 seconds to go 80 yards. The final 67 on that pass from Jason Campbell to Aroma Shadu, and the Auburn Tigers have now scored on their first possession in 6 of 7 games. If DeCorey Birmingham returns this kickoff, he will become the all-time return yards leader. The mark currently held by Ken Hatfield, and all Birmingham needs to replace the Rice coach is 2 yards. And he backs up, will return it from the goal line, goes right, and is nailed as he gets out near the 17-yard line. But DeCorey Birmingham in the books after the Carlos Rogers tackle. That's a mark that goes back to the mid-60s, Todd.
Well, let's go back to the touchdown catch by Aroma Shadu. Now, here he is, and he's going to show block and then release. The thing I want you to watch are these two safeties. They've had 2 weeks to prepare for Auburn, and they've been well-schooled. Be ready for an early reverse. Well, they read the reverse, and they both break up, and that allowed Aroma Shadu to run right past him to the heart of the defense. An excellent call by offensive coordinator Al Borges on the first Auburn possession, and Jason Campbell off to a fast start.
Aroma Shadu had to await the football. Here's play action. Matt Jones rolling right Under some pressure from Edens, he completes his first pass out to Marcus Monk, number 85. The true freshman who is starting his second consecutive games now, Kevin Spears with the pressure. But a pickup of 18 for the dangerous Matt Jones.
You know, I watch film every Thursday, and this Thursday, after I got done watching the games, Auburn had a particular group of plays put together called the Matt Jones package. And I sat down and watched this, and I just wish I would have had a Coke and some popcorn to watch it. It was one of the most enjoyable things I got to watch, him making big plays in the last couple years. And he is a dynamic football player.
Out of the shotgun, he hands it off. It's Kyle Dickerson, number 29, who comes left and is stopped at the 37-yard line. Let's take a look at Matt Jones in action.
Well, what makes him so unusual is his size and speed, and his speed is deceptive. Because he's tall and he doesn't look like he's moving fast, you don't think he's that fast, but everybody takes bad angles on him. And then this year, he's been throwing the ball better than he has at any point in his career. He is a big play guy, and the entire team feeds off of him.
Second down and 8. He comes near side. It's Marcus Monk, and Monk has another Arkansas first down. Marcus Monk, a true freshman out of Lepanto, Arkansas, small area. That's a 17-yard gain for the 6'6 Marcus Monk. Offensive line, Hugo, Parker, Roper, Perry, and Gilbo gets his first start of his career today, replacing the injured Zach Tubbs. Birmingham, Kennedy in the backfield, Harris, Monk, and Jared Hicks is the tight end. Here is Houston Nutt in his seventh season as the head coach at Arkansas. Four wideouts out of the spread. Jones stands tough, fires it out, caught at the 43-yard line by Stephen Harris, number 84. And Carlos Rogers makes the tackle. Auburn defense, they lost five guys up front from last year's team. They have replaced them, and they're playing well. Longenfeld, Jackson Ratliff, and Brett Edmonds. Linebackers, small but fast. Sears, Travis Williams, and Terrius Williams. The secondary, Pitts, Junior Rose Green, four interceptions against Tennessee. Kennedy is the fullback, and Birmingham gets a late handoff. Cuts back to his right inside the 40, down at the 39, and Travis Williams, number 51, made the tackle.
And I thought it was interesting when we talked to Auburn defensive coordinator yesterday, Gene Chizik. He said in defending Matt Jones, their philosophy and what they've stressed all week is trying to get a player and a half on him on every play, because he has a unique ability to make the first guy miss. That's Chizik right there standing up in the middle. Because of Jones' elusiveness, they've got to get more than one body around him, for after he makes the first guy miss, the second guy's there to finish him off.
Third and two. Fires it. Monk has his third catch of the first drive, and he's got a first down. Marcus Monk, number 85. He's a true freshman. He was the valedictorian of his small high school class. He will play basketball this year for the Arkansas Razorback basketball team. He was elevated to a starting spot 2 weeks ago, and it caused Carlos Owsley to quit the team in anger.
But this guy deserves to be starting. Marcus Monk is a very special football player. He's a great big target for Matt Jones to throw to. They have an immediate bond. It's probably that shared love for basketball, but they really have a good chemistry together.
Here's DeCorey Birmingham. He is driven down, hard tackle by Stanley McClubber, number 75. He's a young man who made a quick early impression, kind of slacked off and lost his starting spot to Longenfeld, but he makes the tackle there after a gain of one. Carlos Owsley quit the team. Houston Nutt told us, I don't want to waste any oxygen talking about him because he's too selfish. He was really angry at Owsley's deception to leave. And here is Jones. Pumps once, pulls up, overthrows his tight end, Jared Hicks. That's going to bring up a third down.
Well, again, that was a case where even though it was an incomplete pass, there was only one Auburn defender there. It was McGlover, and he got faked out by Matt Jones. He's such an unusual player that you've got to try to get an additional guy near him because of his ability to make people miss.
Look from behind the Auburn defense. Here's Matt Jones. Wide out split, right and left, and Jones from the spread on third and nine. Auburn starts, quick flip. Hicks drops it. Might have been picked off.
Hit the ground.
Incomplete.
It was well defended by Auburn anyway. They tried to, like, sneak the tight end, Jared Hicks, on a little middle screen. Auburn was not fooled. Good pressure immediately. Hicks took his eye off the football. And Arkansas in four down territory here. Fourth and nine, going to go for it.
Yep. Well, they're well outside the range of their field goal kicker, Chris Balsero. And an early gamble by Houston Nutt. Field position at stake here from the 34-yard line. Balsero does not hit from more than 45 yards. The pass is tipped, incomplete. Travis Williams got a left hand on it.
Now, that was a case where it looked like Matt Jones was going to take off and run, and at the last minute, he hesitated and tried to stick it in there to Birmingham, and Travis Williams, with his good speed, able to get a hand on the football. It's a pretty nice answer by the Arkansas offense to start this drive, but now Auburn gets the football again.
7-0 Tigers. On CBS, 7-0 here, 10:46 to go. Second offensive possession now for the Tigers. They scored on a 67-yard pass from Campbell to Aroma Shadoo last time. Ben Obomanu is in tight, and here's Campbell with some pressure. Pulls out, Huckabee comes at him, and the pass is complete to Obomanu, number two, up at the 47-yard line. Well, let's introduce you now to the Arkansas Razorback defense. The line, Harris, Dixon, Titus Peebles gets the start today, and Jeb Huckabee. Linebackers, Pierre Brown, Elijah Butu, and John Jackson. And in the secondary, Michael Coe, Randy Kelly, his first start, a JC transfer, Lorenzo Robinson, and Darius Vinette.
I think a really big thing, these two safeties, Robertson and Kelly, have to play well for Arkansas to have a chance today. They both got fooled on that first touchdown. They've got to play poised and disciplined in the back end.
Here's the toss. It's Cadillac Williams out of a tackle. He's got some room. Carnell Cadillac Williams out of bounds inside the 35. Jeb Huckabee finally got there. Ronnie Brown, number 23, with a clearing block.
One of the things that Al Borges has done is he's gotten Brown and Carnell in the game together. There's Ronnie Brown leading the block right there to open the way for Carnell. And these two in the backfield together have really been something. Neither one of them probably going to have the big-time numbers, but it has made this Auburn defense that much more difficult to defend.
This time it's Williams alone in the backfield. And here's the reverse right side. Here comes Courtney Taylor, and he's still running inside the 10. Oh, he's
stepped out of bounds.
Back at the 19-yard line.
Still another good play, though, and Al Borges mixing it up, taking advantage of this aggressive Arkansas defense. This time, good fake to Carnell. Good job by Jason Campbell of hiding the football, and there's Ronnie Brown leading out again. He was outside as a wide receiver that time. And did a nice job of leading again. There's Al Borges. His first year, came over from Indiana University and has really, he's become a very popular person here on the Plains.
On first down at the 19, Campbell under his center. Draw play. Williams darts left, looks for a block from Taylor.
Good defense.
And Tommy Tuberville. Al Borges hired in the spring. This is the fourth offensive coordinator in his many years here. Noel Mazzone, then Bobby Petrino, who's now the Louisville head coach. Last year was Hugh Knoll. And Al Borges had spent 2 years in what he described as football hell. He got fired at Cal. He then got a job. He said he'd never been fired before. Got a job at Indiana and jumped at the chance when he was offered the position here in the spring.
So they didn't know anything about it except it was a great environment and they had a running back named Cadillac. That was all he knew about Auburn.
And he's learned about grits and sweet tea. Second down. Here's Williams, the aforementioned Cadillac. Well, our Home Depot coach's decision this week is Tommy Tuberville's decision to hire 49-year-old Al Borges.
Well, you take a look at the improvement all the way across the board. And, you know, one of the things that he also did, Al Borges, I think was very smart, is he brought Carnell Williams and Ronnie Brown in right away as soon as he got here and said, hey, look, they call it the West Coast offense, but it's not going to be a passing circus. We're still going to run the football, and you two guys, I'm going to put both of you on the field at the same time a lot.
35 at the 14-yard line. Here's the option play. Will Campbell keeps it. Cuts inside. He's inside the 10. That should be short of the first down.
Nice stop right there by the Arkansas defense. That was a check at the line of scrimmage. Auburn not a big option team, but with the eight-man front of Arkansas, a lot of times good to check to that option, but they came up short. Tommy Tuberville electing to go for three here. Or at least line up for three.
This
could possibly be a fake. Tommy Tuberville known to roll the dice a little bit.
The snapper is Chaz Crowfoot. He came on and replaced Pete Compton in that role after the near bobble against LSU. A couple of bad snaps. Sam Reeves holds it, and John Vaughn kicks it home. John Vaughn for the year now, 7 of 9 with three-point efforts. Big run on the reverse from Courtney Taylor set up the field goal. It's 10-0. Auburn. Auburn leads the Arkansas Razorbacks midway through the first quarter. Well, earlier this week, the college football community lost one of its great ladies. Barbara Broyles died on Wednesday at the age of 79 after a five-year battle with Alzheimer's. Since 1957, Frank and Barbara Broyles served as the first couple of Arkansas athletics. He is the former head football coach. She is a woman of unequaled affability, dignity, and compassion. They were married for 59 years. Barbara Broyles and Frank are survived. Barbara Broyles is survived by 4 sons, 2 daughters, and 19 grandchildren. Houston Nutt, the head coach, said of her, she was an awesome lady and always a giver. Those of us who were lucky enough to know Barbara Broyles could only say that that is a beautiful epitaph for a wonderful lady. Arkansas trailing 10-0. And they'll try the onside kick. Oh, didn't get it. Oh, they had it set up. Junior Rose Green. Yep.
We told you that Tommy Tuberville has been known to roll the dice. He went for the field goal. This time really had the Arkansas kick return team fooled, but they just weren't able to execute it. And the net result is that Arkansas will start their second offensive possession with great field position. Only one Arkansas guy over there, I think that was Marcus Monk, and he wasn't close to the football. It's got to go 10 yards. It did not get 10 yards, and then it went out of bounds before Rose Greens could get it.
Doyle Jackson is the referee today. The penalty is declined, and Arkansas gets it at the 45.
One of the real keys for Arkansas offensively, every game they have two major goals. Number one is to not turn the ball over. Number two is to average at least 4 yards on every first down play. When that last drive stopped, it was because of the 1 yard gain by Birmingham on their first down play. First down, a huge down for Arkansas.
Here's Matt Jones with a play fake. Now here is where he is most dangerous. And it's incomplete. Marcus Monk, the intended receiver. It'll be second down and 10. And let's go down to Tracy Wolfson. Trace.
Thanks, Vern. You talked about the passing of Barbara Broyles. Well, in memory of her, each Arkansas player is wearing a decal with the initials BB on their helmet. Head coach Houston Nutt said this is a remembrance of a great, great lady who is always so kind and graceful and giving. He said she will always be the first lady of the Razorbacks.
Oh, thank you, BB. Frank Broyles chatted with Houston Nutt after Barbara passed away on Wednesday, and he insisted that Coach Nutt, here's the coach in Frank, he insisted that Coach Nutt accompany the team down yesterday. Here's Jones. say Houston Nutt was not present at the funeral services in Fayetteville. There's a tackle on second down. It'll be third and long.
That is called swarming to Matt Jones. That's a perfect example of getting more than one defender to the quarterback. He's going to keep it. He makes first guys miss most of the time. But when there's four blue shirts there, it's a lot easier to corral him. And now another third down and long situation. Not the best of situations for this Arkansas offense.
The area is Howard and places DeCorey Birmingham, and Matt Jones is in the spread. Here comes the blitz from the outside, and we'll have a dead ball foul. Kevin Sears, the linebacker, was across the line.
Movement. I think the new right tackle that's in there, Matt Gilbo, took off a little early. You know, they'll miss Zach Tubbs with his experience and maturity. Zach Tubbs had the most experience of any of the returning Arkansas offensive linemen, but what they lack in experience with Gilbo, maybe they might make up with in athleticism, maybe a little more athletic than the older Tubbs.
Third and 13. Draw play. It's Birmingham, and he gets back to the 40 and then the 39-yard line. That's going to bring up another fourth down. Well, we mentioned those who Owsley left the team. Zach Tubbs, Derek Moore, both out with broken legs, suffered in practice, and a big loss, Peyton Hillis.
Yeah, I think he's the biggest loss right there, because not only was he valuable in goal line and short yardage, but an outstanding receiver coming out of the backfield. Back injury in that Florida game, out for a few more weeks.
Well, Jacob Skinner is on punt. Excuse me, Tom.
I was just going to say the gamble paid off for Tuberville. It didn't look like it was a good decision, but Arkansas unable to move the football.
Here's Skinner. Carnell Williams awaits the punt at the 10-yard line. This one comes near side, and can they get it?
They're saying the ball crossed the plane.
Right.
The man can go into the end zone as long as the ball doesn't cross the plane. Darius Vinette tried to save it. The ruling that the ball crossed the plane, I think that's a good call.
Touchback, Auburn. They get the ball for the third time. And they get it leading 10-0. A 67-yard pass followed by a field goal. 10-0 Auburn.
Troop 130 of Talladega.
6:09 to go first quarter, Auburn by 10. Get complete college football coverage at CBS Sportsline. And a reminder, fantasy basketball leagues are forming now. Get in on the action by clicking on fantasy basketball at CBSSportsline.com.
First and 10, Auburn at the Tiger 20.
From the 20, Jeremy Engel over the ball, Jason Campbell the quarterback, and Jake Slaughter is in the fullback. Leads the way as Ronnie Brown comes right. Ronnie Brown getting a play at tailback, and we check in with Tim Brando back in New York.
Vernon Todd, USC, barely got past Cal last week. How about Arizona State this week? Matt Leinart to Reggie Bush, 7-0. Arizona State, by the way, had a field goal blocked from 47 yards. Trojans lead early.
That game's a real test of the mental toughness of USC. After the emotional win against Cal last week, they've got to come right back this week.
Ronnie Brown breaks into the secondary and is down at the 30-yard line. Looks like that will be enough for a first down. Well, Auburn, the national rankings this season, they started at 17th, fell two, and since then it's been a rapid climb into the top 10.
Yeah, and you know, the theme we've heard all week, what a difference a year makes. Last year when the season started, they started right here at 6 and immediately went this way. I mean, it's just been a complete difference. They kind of came in under the radar to start the season. This year, they've taken care of business, and they've gotten better each week.
Had that game here, which we televised against Southern California, and they lost it 20-3. Here's Campbell, right side, Romishadu. He's got it. A little tap dance on the sidelines. Got his feet down, a 21-yard gain for Devin Aromishadu.
And what a beautiful throw by Jason Campbell. No pressure on him. He's very relaxed and comfortable right over the outstretched hand of Michael Coe. And Aromishadu able to catch it and get 1 foot down on the sidelines. Beautiful touch over a defender who was in pretty good possession.
And a backfield substitution now as Aroma Shadu comes to the near side. Campbell perfect 4-4. And Carl Stewart is in the backfield. He's a freshman redshirt. And he is joined by Ronnie Brown. This is the tight end in motion to the left side. Quick flip. Carl Stewart. He's got it there. Flags down.
Yeah. Dixon was offsides, and it looked like some of the Arkansas players stopped on the play. Auburn did not. Doesn't stop the clock or stop the play.
Well, Houston, that he's indicating it should be a legal procedure.
Yeah, he's thinking that Dixon got drawn offside.
Right.
And maybe that is what happened. No, they're marching the other way.
Well, it's offside by the defense. Penalty is 5 yards from the previous spot, followed by repeating the first down.
I think Doyle forgot that they're supposed to announce the numbers of the guilty parties this year.
That's right.
Take a look right there in the pit. Aaron Dixon not able to get back before the play started.
At the 43.
And a first down and 5. Silas Daniels is on as a wide out. He's wide to the left side now. Here's Campbell, fakes the draw and goes for his tight end. Out into the right flat, incomplete. 10-0 here. Let's go back to New York. Once again, Tim Brando.
Well, Vern, much like Michigan, Texas is one of the best teams in the country once they've gotten that loss. Brian Robinson picks off Brad Smith, takes it into the end zone. They have the early advantage over that journalism school from the Big 12, Missouri.
Oh, that journalism school from the Big 12, the alma mater of our producer, Craig Silver. Second down and 5. Lonnie Brown leans up as Campbell appears to be making a change at the line. Here's Brown at the 41-yard line. Elliott Harris, number 98.
This is an important series for the Arkansas defense. They obviously have come out with a lot of enthusiasm, a lot of energy, a couple good play calls by Auburn, have gotten some big plays on them. They can't afford to go down much further. One of the real problems that they've had is giving up big plays and getting behind early in games like they did 2 weeks ago against Florida. There's Dave Womack, the defensive coordinator. He said our guys are going to be ready to play, but they just can't afford to give up any more easy plays.
Third and 3. Courtney Taylor comes in. They bunch to the left side. Mix and Obomanu are also there. Here's Campbell back. Little crossing pattern underneath, and the pass is complete to the 31-yard line. Courtney Taylor, number 11. Taylor, the leading receiver, coming in with 17 catches.
This is one of the things that Al Borges has brought to the Auburn offense. A lot of different sets with these bunch sets. And what that does is it makes it difficult for defenses to get lined up. And because it takes them longer to get lined up, they aren't able to generate a lot of consistent pressure on Jason Campbell. And Campbell, for the most part this whole season, has been able to be comfortable in the pocket, and he's throwing the football very accurately.
And another first down and 10 after the gain of 11. Ronnie Brown in his boxer stance. Timeout call. And the timeout comes with 3 minutes and 38 seconds to go first quarter. Houston nuts Arkansas Razorbacks. Trail by 10. Jordan-Hare Stadium on the campus at Auburn, about a half mile from this intersection. This is Toomer's Corner. And that is the main intersection in Auburn, Toomer's Drugstore. And one of the traditions here is after a victory, the students and fans head to Toomer's Corner and paper the trees. And those of a suspicious, superstitious bent here don't like it, Todd, when we come to town. We've never seen the place papered. Here's Campbell back, right side. Courtney Taylor, man coverage, got it. Touchdown, Auburn. Beautiful, beautiful pass. And a pretty decent catch.
There is a flag down. I don't think it's going to wave off the touchdown. Jason Campbell, the last 3 weeks, has just been throwing the ball beautifully. particularly on the deep throws. Excellent touch over the outside shoulder. Beautiful. 6 of 7, 149 yards, and 2 touchdown passes already for Jason Campbell.
John Vaughn is on for the extra point. Here's the extra point is up, and it is good. And those of you who are big fans of extra point records, that's 208 extra points in succession for the Auburn Tigers. Courtney Taylor over Michael Coe, a rainbow-like pass right in his waiting arms. .331 to go opening quarter, 17-0 now. Another pass from Jason Campbell. This one into the waiting hands of Courtney Taylor, and Philip Yost will kick off. 17-0, and a capacity crowd announced 87,451. Cedric Washington decides to run it out. Oh, that looks suspiciously like Xavier Carter in our game of a couple of weeks ago.
Let's go back and take another look at the touchdown. Now, right here is Courtney Taylor, and look at this hard inside technique by the cornerback. That tells Jason Campbell it's probably going to be man-to-man. They kept both backs in. This is only a two-man route. They caught everybody in to block, and a perfect throw against man coverage by Jason Campbell.
And on the kickoff, Todd, there was a flag thrown. It's going to be an infraction against the Razorbacks. So it will come back to the 7-yard line, 8-yard line.
And one of the things about this Arkansas team, they're very young. Only 9 seniors that Houston Nutt has on this team. Matt Jones, of course, one of them. But a young team on the road, down 17-0. You've got to do a lot of work just to keep them from losing it here. And they've got to keep them in the football game. And Matt Jones is a good guy to have with the ball in his hands.
Nobody open. Goes deep right side into double coverage. It's almost picked off. Intended for Marcus Monk. Well, 6-0, the record for the Tigers of Auburn. And they have excelled in the first half.
Yeah, they really have. And they've jumped on people early. You know, some of the teams that they've played, they've just been a lot better than. But 17 points today, the most that they've done in the first quarter. And the bad news for Arkansas, the second quarter has been the quarter that they've had the most problem in. So hold on to your hats.
2nd and 10. Birmingham out across the 10 near the 12-yard line.
You know, the one thing that I'm impressed with right away in the first quarter with Auburn, and it's kind of the opposite of what we didn't see last week with Georgia. Georgia had the big win over LSU. They came back the next week, and they were not a focused football team. A lot of penalties, a lot of mental mistakes. This Auburn team, this is their 7th game, and every game they have come ready to play. They've been focused, and we're seeing that on both offense and defense. This is a team that is, you know, the old cliche of taking one game at a time. This team has put it into practice.
And I think that in part is a reflection of the fact that they have 18 seniors who participate. Here's Jones on 3rd down, and that's where he is so effective.
Jones up right in.
Well, that was a critical 1st down, too, because if they don't convert this and have to punt from their end zone and Auburn gets it again with good field position, it's going to be tough. But Matt Jones, again, he's so deceptively fast that most defenders take poor angles against him because they don't think he's running that fast until they're looking at the back of his jersey.
The Arius Howard is in the backfield now, along with Brandon Kennedy. Kennedy is the fullback. Howard tries to follow Kennedy's block, and he has to cut it back to his left. Not much there. T.J. Jackson and Jay Ratliff were the two who were most responsible for that.
You mentioned this Auburn defense had to replace 5 of their front 7 from a year ago, a couple big-time players. Carlos Dansby, one of the most decorated defensive player in Auburn history, actually here at the game today, has a week off in the NFL. And this is more of a no-name defense, but they're actually playing with a lot more depth. A lot more guys are playing, and statistically, they're a little bit better than that defense last year was at this point in the season.
Second down and 10. Play fake. Jones dances out to the left, pulls up, fires his sidearm, is tipped and incomplete. And that was Carlos Rogers, the defender on Marcus Monk, number 14.
And when we talked to Houston Nutt, he said to us, he has lunch every Tuesday with Matt Jones. He said, Matt, I love it when the ball's in your hands, but one thing you can't do against this defense is throw the ball across the middle of the field, across your body. He got away with it that time, incomplete. But this Auburn defense, 11 interceptions on the season, second only to Kansas, and very fast breaking on the football. Can't get away with that kind of throw very often.
And Jones has now missed his last six passes. Four-man rush for Auburn. Jones right side in and out of the hands of the intended receiver, David Thompson. For more on this Auburn defense, let's get down to Tracy Wolfson.
Thanks, guys. You talked about this no-name Auburn defense. Well, I spoke to Junior Rosengreen, the safety, about this defense, and he said, last year we had people who were all about I, and there's no I in team. Rosengreen said, this year there's much better chemistry, a brotherhood. They spent a lot of time on and off the field together during spring, and they started clicking. Now they have a unique bond that has allowed them to be successful.
Thank you, Tracy. Jacob Skinner is on to punt. And we heard that over and over yesterday, not only from Junior Rosengreen, but Cadillac Williams, Ronnie Brown, Jason Campbell. They all talked about the chemistry of this team. Here's Skinner's punt. And Cadillac Williams gathers it in at the 35-yard line. There's a block that is ruled legal, no flag.
That should have been a flag. That looked like a block in the back.
A 46-yard punt.
Auburn with outstanding field position again. They've got the ball at their own 47. And they are up by 17 with 1:08 to go, first quarter. Jake Slaughter is the fullback, number 44. Ronnie Brown is the tailback. Blitz, Brown, big hole. Huckabee got him, but not before he picked up 13.
See, you can say all you want about the West Coast offense and what Al Borges has changed about the offense. He changed the passing game. He didn't really change the running game. This is vintage Auburn football. I formation, good athletic offensive line, and two outstanding tailbacks in Carnell Williams and Ronnie Brown. I mean, Al Borges said, I'm not going to, you know, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. I'll work on the passing game. I'll make some change with that, but we're going to still run the football with these two tailbacks we have.
That was Randy Kelly, number six, who was left picking up the lingerie. And here is the toss to Brown again. This time he is brought down. John Jackson, number five, led the way. Well, Jason Campbell has been, I think, acknowledged as the beneficiary of this new passing game, though.
Yeah.
And this is the Argent Mortgage quarterback comparison.
Well, you look at his numbers. I mean, they're all better on the right side there in 2004. And, you know, he's actually taken more pressure off the quarterback because the formations, the shifts, the movements, it's not allowed people to really generate a lot of consistent pressure on Jason Campbell, and he has thrown the ball extremely well.
That's the end of the first quarter with our score 17-0, Auburn. We'll return to Jordan-Hare Stadium after this message and a word from your local station. Jason Campbell, the senior quarterback from Auburn, out of Taylorsville, Mississippi, about a 4.5-hour drive away and off to a torrid start in the first quarter. Now we begin quarter number two. Vern Lundquist, Todd Blackledge, and Tracy Wolfson here at Jordan-Hare Stadium. 17-0. It's second and 9. Campbell will throw. Screen pass. Left side. And that one did not work terribly effectively. Well, Todd, you and I have seen Jason Campbell a number of times over the last 4 years. Do you see a decided difference in him?
Well, not a real difference physically. I mean, he always could throw the football. The thing I see is that he's very comfortable. And when he's comfortable, he plays well. You know, when you get pressure on him and he has to move around, he doesn't see the field quite as well. But at this point, this year in this offense, he's been very comfortable. And he's throwing the ball with great accuracy. Probably more precision on the deep balls than I've seen him at any point in his career.
25th consecutive start. That's the longest since Stan White. In the early 90s, Stan White, now a member of the Auburn radio broadcasting crew. Here's Campbell across the middle. Caught by Anthony Mix. And Mix fights for additional yardage all the way to the 15. A gain of 26.
There's just no pressure on Jason Campbell. And part of that is the offensive line doing a nice job. Part of it is the play calling of Al Borges, mixing it up, keeping the Arkansas defense on their heels. And whatever it is, it's allowing Jason Campbell to get set up, to feel comfortable, to not feel rushed, and to throw the ball with accuracy. And he's spreading it around to a lot of different guys.
Anthony Mix with his first catch today. Campbell is 8 of 9 for 172 yards and 2 touchdowns. Here's the reverse. Comes left. Silas Daniels, number 85. Yeah, Jason Campbell's day has been highlighted by a 67-yard toss on the opening series.
Yeah, well, his first pass was a short one that got him into a rhythm, and then they went for the trick play early in the first possession. All alone, Aroma Shadu for the touchdown, and then the next touchdown, a beautiful throw against good coverage into the corner of the end zone. And Jason Campbell picking up right where he left off last week against La Tech, the week before against Tennessee. Hard to imagine a quarterback playing any better than Jason Campbell for the last 3 weeks.
Second down and 9, Campbell from the spread. Screen pass near side, and Ronnie Brown bobbles but then gets it. And Ronnie Brown inside the 10, inside the 5, and that might be, well, let's see, they're going to, where is the spot? Close to the first down. Jeremy Harrell, number 97, with the tackle, first and goal.
I think one of the things that has really come to light this year with the Auburn offense is how versatile Ronnie Brown is. I mean, we've always known that he's a great running back along with Carnell Williams, but his ability to catch the ball out of the backfield and make plays out in space as a receiver has really changed the dynamics of this Auburn offense. It has made them that much more difficult to defend because of his versatility.
Double tight end set. I formation slaughter the fullback, and Ronnie Brown gets the handoff. Bounces off a tackle, picks up 2 yards down to the 3.
Number 23, Ronnie Brown.
Jason Campbell. Attempts per touchdown in 2003, 29. That's now down to 11.7. And attempts per interception, it was 36.6 a year ago, up to 58.5. this year.
And now 12 touchdowns on the season against only 2 interceptions. He was the MVP of last year's Music City Bowl and then has just taken off under this new offensive system brought in by Al Borges.
Brown and Slaughter again, the backs in the eye. On second down, the handoff to Ronnie Brown. He hurdles and is brought down just short.
You know, one other point about Jason Campbell and what he's gone through in his career here at Auburn. He's been a starter since his freshman year, and everybody has said, well, he's had 4 different offensive coordinators in 4 years, and they've said it in a negative way. And that is difficult for a quarterback, but the one positive about that is that he's been exposed to a lot of different offensive philosophies and a lot of football. So when Al Borges came in and started talking to him, he realized, hey, this kid knows a lot about the game. He knows a lot about playing the position, and that transition this year was not nearly as difficult as it might have been for someone else.
Asked for quiet on third and goal. And it'll be Brown for the 3rd time. Touchdown, Auburn.
4 offensive possessions, 4 scores.
Tough afternoon for Houston Nutt and the Arkansas Razorbacks. John Vaughn on to attempt the extra point. He's hit 53 in a row. Make it 54. and extend the string of successful PATs for Auburn to 209.
Ronnie Brown up over the top. He got him down there. They let him pay it off with the touchdown. Four scores in four possessions for the Auburn offense.
It has been a near-perfect game on a near-perfect afternoon for the Auburn Tigers, 24-0. Ronnie Brown got that last touchdown. They're impressive.
They are, and I was anxious to see them in person to see if they were as good as advertised, and I think that they are. I saw them on tape against Tennessee, but there were six turnovers in that game, so I really wasn't sure if they were as good as it looked like they were. They looked that good today.
Yost with a kickoff. This will chase Cedric Washington back and goes through the end zone. Touchback. It'll come out to the 20. Wednesday on the season premiere of The King of Queens, see why going to a health spa may actually be hazardous to your health. The King of Queens returns Wednesday on CBS, America's most watched network.
As Arkansas comes back on the field, again, it's their offense. I mean, this is the number one ranked offense in the SEC coming in behind Matt Jones, but it all starts on first down. They've got to be effective on first down. Their last four first down plays have netted them 0 yards.
Matt Jones will go from the spread. Bring Cedric Washington over to the near side. There's an option. And Jones, he's got speed.
He may go all the way.
Carlos Rogers, the only man who can stop him, and Rogers does.
Number nine.
This is vintage Matt Jones, because Will Herring, the free safety, had him with nobody blocking him and took a bad angle because he underestimated the speed of Matt Jones. A little radar option. There's a guy there for him, Herring. He freezes him and then outruns him to the corner. And if it were not for Carlos Rogers, Arkansas would be on the scoreboard. But there is a good first down play for Arkansas.
54-yard gain, his longest run of the season, and en route, he has become the leader in rushing yards by a quarterback in SEC history. He needed 55 coming in. And to Corey Birmingham with a carry there.
And then right back to a stop on first down. Now it's second and 10. And that's the situation that they've wanted to avoid today.
And it is time appropriately now for
Aflac.
Here's the question of the week. Who did hold the SEC record?
Yeah, I held.
Who did hold it for career rushing yards by a quarterback? Answer will coming up. The new record holder is Matt Jones. Boy, we're timely.
Mm-hmm.
Just Johnny on the spot. Play fake. Jones. Look at him. He's a joy to watch. Goes deep. Ill-advised pass.
He's
got
to run that, though.
Yes.
That's too hard of a throw to make for a right-handed quarterback rolling to his left. But he had a lot of green grass out there. He's got to take advantage of his ability to run with the football. He gets flushed out of the pocket. He's trying to keep the play alive, but keep it alive with your legs. It's easier than making that throw rolling to your left.
There was a pitcher for the Kansas City Royals named Dan Quisenberry.
Mm-hmm.
Got to know him. Remember the underhanded throw?
Sir.
Yeah, Dan. Late Dan Quisenberry. He kind of reminds me of that, you know. But I think Houston Nutt needs to keep him at lunch a little longer and make sure he understands. Most yards per play coming in. Jones trailing Danny Werfel, the Heisman winner. Here's DeCorey Birmingham. What a nice defensive play by Carlos Rogers.
You got to run north and south on this defense. This is not a big Auburn defense, but they play fast. You can't go side to side against this defense as Birmingham tries to do here. You're not going to sprint to the corner outside of this defense. Carlos Rogers there and makes the stop. See here again on that second down play. If Matt Jones runs instead of throws, instead of being third and 10, it's maybe third and 2. As it is now, it's fourth and 10.
And they have no option but to go for it. Steps up, had a man wide open, and threw it behind him. Washington. Cedric Washington at the 5-yard line all by himself.
No, this didn't look like good communication. Washington is right here. He's going to run into the seam, and Matt Jones is going to throw the ball behind him.
Washington gets in there. Jones throws it before the receiver's head is turned around. And Auburn gets the ball.
CBS Sports coverage of the Home Depot SEC on CBS will continue after this word from your local station.
Back in New York, Tim Brando. After an interception of Andrew Walter, USC's Matt Leinart, this time instead of a running back, goes to a wide receiver, Dwayne Jarrett, 19 yards. I think they've answered that mental test that Todd was talking about. Let's get back to Vern.
All right, thank you, Todd. Todd, Tim, I'll be all right. 24-0. 9:02 to go. Jason Campbell and the Auburn Tigers rolling. Fake toss. Campbell goes out to his right under pressure and completes it at the 30-yard line. The catch made by Cooper Wallace, number 8.
And the first grass stain on Jason Campbell's uniform. First time.
Second down and 6. Mentioned his dad's a high school coach in Taylorsville, Mississippi. Very successful high school coach. Jason telling us that they're having a tough year this time. They played last night, and that's his dad in the middle of the screen, his mom, Carolyn, father, Larry, and made the trip over this morning, and they'll head back tonight. We're 2-5 going into last night's game. Second down. Here's the toss. Cadillac Williams got a big block out in front. Marcus McNeil blotted out the sun.
Yeah, he's the best lineman on this Auburn team. Big number 73, a junior, 6'9", 330 pounds, out of Decatur, Georgia. Probably will be off to the NFL at the end of this season, but he is very athletic for a man that size. Again, Ronnie Brown leading from the fullback position, and Marcus McNeil just clearing the way down the left side.
And a first down and 10 at the 45-yard line. Make it to 44 officially. Slaughter and Williams are the backs. And this time nothing doing on the first down play. Marcus Whitmore, number 17, makes the tackle. First four possessions for the Tigers. Pretty impressive.
Yep. And just good balance. I mean, they've kept Arkansas's defense off balance with a couple reverses and some trick plays, but then the mixture of the run and pass have kept the pass rush pressure off of Jason Campbell.
Al Borges, who got his start in Salinas, California as a high school coach, coaching the Wishbone, the old Wishbone offense. Here's Anthony Mix, and he's on a roll down the right side.
Now this is something that I have not been used to seeing Jason Campbell do in his career earlier. He comes out looking to his left. Watch Jason Campbell. He's going to look this way first and not see what he likes. So he quickly is going to look back to the right and find a secondary receiver in Anthony Mix. That's a quick decision, a quick reaction, and then Mix makes two Arkansas defenders miss and turns a short completion into a big gain. But it starts with the eyes of Jason Campbell.
210 yards in the first half. This looks reminiscent of his first half against Tennessee when he was 12 of 15 in the first half for 240 yards. Keep it on the ground on the first down play. That'll bring up second down 6. And let's go back to the studio for a Pontiac game-changing performance. Here's Tim.
Well, guys, we had an overtime game earlier today. Watch Boston College's Larry Lester. He fumbles the football in overtime, already down by 3. And Pitt's Thomas Smith stripped him. That was the difference maker. Pittsburgh gets a much-needed win.
All right, Tim, thank you. Second down and 6 here. And this is kind of gaudy. Already in the first quarter and a half, Auburn with 312 yards of total offense. Add to it. And as you know, Todd, you remember this Arkansas defense was gouged a couple of times.
Well, the two teams that can run the football that Arkansas has played both hurt them. Texas ran the football well against them, as did Alabama. And Auburn running it right at him now. Ronnie Brown leading the way. Carnell Williams running it. these two backs. I go back to when Al Borges took the job. You know, there was some speculation Carnell and Ronnie or Ronnie might both opt for the NFL after their junior years. He sat them down and said, look, we're not going to throw it all over the place. We're still going to run the ball, and we're going to play both of you at the same time. A great move to get them excited about this season.
On first down, Slaughter leads Cadillac Williams to the right side. Good defensive pursuit by Arkansas this time. It'll be a gain of one. Pierre Brown, number 27, with the stop.
You know, we talked about Texas running the ball well against this Arkansas defense and also Alabama. The big difference, though, Auburn has the passing game to go with it. Texas, not a very good passing team. Alabama, the time we saw them without Brody Croyle, not much of a passing team. Auburn's got it all going right now. I mean, when you gain over 300 yards in the first half against anybody, you got some good balance.
Well, their most recent road trip, they were down 35-7 to Florida. Came back to make a game of it, but in that game they were susceptible to Chris Leak's passing. He threw for 322 yards in that game. Here's Campbell back, bumps, goes deep, and there's a little contact in the end zone. That will be a hold.
And unnecessary, because the ball was not going to be caught. It was way over the head of the intended receiver, but Dallas Washington, a backup safety in the game, just reached out and grabbed his man. Cole Bennett, number 87, the tight end, was the intended receiver, and the ball was well over his head when the penalty occurred.
Foul is pass interference by number 43 on the defense. Penalty will place the ball at the 2-yard line.
First and goal, Auburn.
Boy, this is just an Arkansas team that is out of whack. Here's the penalty right here. The ball is thrown to Cole Bennett. It's going to be over his head and probably uncatchable. And no need for the penalty by Washington.
And instead, it's first and goal from the 2. And you can see this overwhelming statistical edge, 323 yards already. And we've got 443 to go before the break. First down and goal. Backs in the eye. Carnell Williams skips right. Touchdown, Auburn. John Vaughn will come on and try the extra point. Thinking about Cody Bliss, the punter. He's going to get lonesome before the day's over.
Well, he hasn't punted in the first half for the last 3 weeks, and it might be 4 if this keeps going like this.
Jazz Crowfoot will snap it back. Reeves will hold it. The kick is up, and it's good.
Here's the flag.
Flag down. Over on the far side of the field.
Vern, so far this season, we've seen Florida, we've seen Tennessee, we've seen LSU, we've seen Georgia, and now we've seen Auburn. And I think clearly this, at this point, is the best team, the most complete team in the Southeastern Conference.
Doyle Jackson.
Foul is only 6 on the line by the kicking team. Penalty is 5 yards from the previous spot, followed by a retry.
We chatted with Tommy Tuberville yesterday, talking about the difference last year to this. And, of course, there was the much, much publicized trip in Bobby Lauder's plane to Louisville when the former president of this university tried to lead a charge and get Bobby Petrino to come back here, even though Tommy Tuberville was still under contract. And Tommy said the fact that it got publicized, it's no good. Oh, my gosh. The streak comes to an end. 209 in a row. Now, as you remember, they missed one against LSU. A bad snap, and there was a penalty. Here's John Vaughn's first miss of his career. And the first one in the last 209, the longest current streak in the nation. Here's next week's Aflac question.
Nothing sacred.
What's the longest? Syracuse, 262. Jordan-Hare Stadium on the campus of Auburn University, 30-0, Auburn, 4:36 remaining in the first half. Philip Yost will kick off after John Vaughn's shocking miss of the extra point. And here's Yost. This will chase Washington all the way back out of the end zone. Well, it's been an Auburn onslaught in this game.
Carnell Williams shows you the little bit of the difference between he and Ronnie Brown. Pops probably a little bit faster than Ronnie Brown, able to bounce that one out to the outside. But Tommy Tuberville's team just very focused. Good play calling, good mixture of run and pass, and some talented guys at key positions. Jason Campbell playing great football. Carnell Williams and Ronnie Brown running it, catching it out of the backfield.
Dedrick Poole is in as the deep back in the eye. He gets the handoff on first down, and number one spurts over the left side for a gain of eight. Well, time now for the answer to our trivia question of the week, and my partner, Mr. Blackledge, gets to do a double dip here. Not only the Affleck question, but who's the answer?
Bond. John Bond.
We have no shame. Mississippi State quarterback, 1980 to 1983, still lives in Starkville. Probably doesn't have quite as much hair now as he did back then.
Probably not.
First and 10 here. Let's go back to our New York studios. Once again, here's Tim.
All right, Vernon Todd. Well, Texas out to that early lead, but after an interception thrown by Vince Young, Damian Nash cracks back 33 yards, and we're tied at 14 in Austin. By the way, Todd, I've heard Sean Connery. You're no Sean Connery.
Thanks for pointing that out.
Yes. First down and 10. Here's Jones rolling to his left, being chased by McClubber. Caught and dropped. Stanley McClubber, that is his fourth sack of the season. And it's only the fifth time that Matt Jones has been tackled for a loss on the passing play.
Well, Stanley McClubber is not your typical defensive lineman. You just look at him. He looks more like a tight end. He's 6'3", 250 pounds with outstanding speed out of Fort Lauderdale, Florida. And there to wrap up Matt Jones. That was not one and a half guys there. That was just one. But in this case, Stanley was enough.
Well, this Auburn team now does it defensively. Second and 19. Dedrick Poole gets the handoff. He's got a lot of room. Spins out to the 40-yard line. It'll be third down and two. And let's get some more on this Auburn team from Tracy Wolfson. Grace.
Thanks, Vern. Everyone we spoke to on Auburn said unity is one of the reasons for this team's success. It's very obvious here on the sideline after each score. The offense is huddled up together. There's a lot of high-fiving and hugs going on. Even other coaches have taken notice of this team's unity. Mississippi State head coach Sylvester Croom said he witnessed it firsthand when they played in September, and he showed his team a tape of Auburn on the sidelines and how they are a true team. He said with this talent and chemistry on this team, they will be tough to beat. Back to you.
Well, I certainly would agree, Trace, after what we've seen here in the first half. And Houston Nutt would probably concur as well. 30-0, Arkansas timeout, 2:32 to go.
Third and three.
All right, thank you, Tim. 30-0 here. Auburn rolling, leading with 2:32 to go before the halftime break. Third and two. Matt Jones gets a good block, flips it out, it's caught. That'll be good for the first down. Cedric Washington, and an assistant coach goes down, or one of the ball boys, I guess it is.
Yeah.
The sidelines can be a dangerous place.
Oh, he's got to keep your eyes up. His eyes were up, but his hands were full, too. He's got two footballs in his hand, can't get out of the way, but he didn't fumble. He got hit and held on to both balls. Nicely done.
Good on you, lad.
And his sunglasses stayed on, too.
First and 10. This is Darius Howard, number 26, out to the 45-yard line. Well, the Razorbacks lost the ball on downs, two punts, and then lost the ball on downs again.
But they actually, you know, they did a few nice things, and they moved into Auburn territory three times. But the one time they had to punt, and two times they failed on fourth down. So it's they've shown an ability to come back this season, but they could sure use a little score here right before halftime.
Now they were down to Florida 35-7. They did come back and trailed only 38-30. And here's Marcus Monk. Not only tall, but he's got a little swiftness afoot. And that's a first down inside the 20-yard line, a gain of 35. Tackle made by Karibi Didi, number 21.
Well, the immediate comparisons when they were recruiting Marcus Monk from Houston Nutt and the staff was Randy Moss, because he's tall, he's a basketball player, not quite the same kind of speed as Randy Moss, but very few people in the world have the same kind of speed as Randy Moss.
First and 10, 30-0, with 1:23 to go, fumble. Jones picks it up, gets it in the hands of his running back, and the tackle made by Kevin Hobbs on Dedrick Poole. And timeout called Arkansas. That's their second. Leaves them with one. Here's the bobble, Matt Jones. Time called, 1:14 remaining before the break. 1:14 to go before the halftime break. We'll go back to New York. Tim Brando with the Earthlink halftime report. Scores and highlights as we reach the midway point of this 2004 college football season. Second and nine, Arkansas trying to get something on the board before halftime. Chris Baker, Stephen Harris, and Cedric Washington to the left side. Here's Jones back. Pulls up, goes deep in the end zone. Touchdown! Got it! Catch is made by Chris Baker, number 28.
Chris Baker.
Don't count out Matt Jones. I mean, I know they've got a steep hill to climb here, but getting a score right before halftime, now if they can stop Auburn, that'll be key. But the three receivers, Baker gets to the end zone and then finds the open area, and Matt Jones sticks him with the football. Nice job by Matt Jones stepping up in the pocket and finding Baker for the score.
Chris Balsero with the extra point attempt now. Dowell Watkins will hold it. It is up and good. And just a footnote before halftime, Arkansas won the toss and deferred the option. So they'll get the ball to open the second half. 1:06 to go before the break, however, and it's 30-7, Tigers. Matt Jones finds Chris Baker from 19 yards out, puts Arkansas on the board. A 23-point margin now, 30-7, 1:06 to go before halftime. Arkansas has one timeout remaining, and the Auburn Tigers have two.
How good has this Auburn defense been this year? That's only the second touchdown in the first half that they've allowed. They allowed one to LSU back in September. That just the second one.
David Carlton will kick off for the Razorbacks. This is Carnell Cadillac Williams at the 1 yard line. A runner should do leads the way out. Cadillac Williams breaks the tackle. Flag is down back at the 13 yard line. So this one probably will go south against Auburn.
As Pittsburgh's rookie quarterback Ben Roethlisberger reminded him of Dan Marino, having that kind of impact, has won his first three games as a hot young prospect out of Miami of Ohio.
That was illegal off the back by number 9 during the return. Henley is half the distance to go, followed by a first down.
I thought before that penalty that Auburn might have tried to be aggressive and tried to go right down the field in a two-minute offense, but now backed inside of their 10, they may just try to kill the clock here, and that's what they're going to do. They're lined up in the victory formation, their worst starting field position of the entire first half.
Arkansas with one timeout left, but does not appear they'll exercise that option. Well, rushing to win, the Tigers, when Williams is 50 or more yards in a game, they're 21-5. You can see what happens when he's less than 50, when Ronnie Brown is over 50, 15-2. And then on the bottom, when they both rush for 50, undefeated.
50-50.
What are they today? It's another Affleck question. Suspense is just pervasive. There's the snap. And here's what they have done thus far. Ronnie Brown, 33 yards. Carnell Williams, 65 yards. Well, it was all Auburn all the time until the last 5 minutes of the first half. Tommy Tuberville's bunch rolled out to a 30-0 lead, and they lead at the break 30-7. Let's go down to Tracy, who is with Houston Nutt.
Thanks, Vern. A much-needed touchdown, but your team has given up over 300 yards on offense. How do you slow this Auburn squad down?
I don't know. We haven't been able to do it yet. We got to somehow find a way to tackle better and stop these guys. They're an awfully good offense right now. More importantly, I'm worried about Matt. He's a little bit banged up right now.
What kind of treatment will you give him in the locker room?
Getting iced down right now.
What's his injuries?
Pull groin.
Thanks a lot. Back to you, Vern.
Well, that does not augur well at all. At the end of the first half with our score 30-7, now let's go to Tim Brando in our New York studio. Halftime 30-7, Auburn leads Arkansas. Razorbacks will get the ball to open the second half. 30-7, Auburn leads Arkansas. We'll return to Jordan-Hare for the kickoff to open the third quarter right after this. Auburn leads it 30-7 as we start the third quarter. And Arkansas will get the ball. Let's go down to Tracy Wolfson.
Thanks, Vern. An update on Arkansas quarterback Matt Jones. I spoke to the trainers right after half. They said he heard it early in the game. They iced it. They rewrapped it. And they said he will absolutely be back out there. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Trace.
The question will be, how effective will he be? I mean, trying to come back from a 30-7 deficit with a healthy Matt Jones, a daunting enough task, with one who's not 100%, very, very difficult.
Philip Yost will kick it off. Cedric Washington to your left. Matt Jones on the sideline. And here's the kick by Auburn's Philip Yost. This one will be returned. Washington at the goal line. At the 20. And out to the 26-yard line. Well, I'm sure you've had to play with hamstrings, Todd. How tough is that?
Well, I'm a completely different quarterback where I was than Matt Jones. I mean, for a drop-back guy, a groin injury is not that big a deal because you're going to still try to get back and throw. But for a guy who uses his legs as much as Matt Jones does, as a scrambler, as a runner running the option, it could be a huge injury. And he's obviously the key to this offense. And how he can play with pain and play with this injury will determine a lot about what Arkansas can do in the second half.
On first down, backs in the eye. Play fake. Drills it out incomplete, intended for Marcus Monk.
Intended for number 85.
And again, first down is still the critical down for Arkansas when they have the football. Now, they average nearly 17 yards per play on first down, but one of those was a 54-yard run by Matt Jones. They had six first down plays in that first half that resulted in 0 yards gained. So right there's another one. 0 yards on first down, second and 10. Tough.
Jones back. Devin Poole, number one. Not much there. As he comes right. Let's check the stats at halftime presented by the Hartford.
Now look at the total yards, and 9.2 yards per play Auburn averaged in that first half. And that is phenomenal in terms of what they were able to do, both running and throwing the football. Totally kept the Arkansas defense off balance.
Third and 9. Jones out of the gun. Four-man rush. McClever comes. The pass is complete to Marcus Monk, and that's a first down. Arkansas at the 40-yard line. Will Herring with the tackle.
Nice job by Matt Jones staying right in the pocket. And you can see him. He is obviously hobbling around a little bit, not feeling 100%, but we've seen a little bit of everything out of Matt Jones in his career. Runner, thrower, competitor, leader. Now we're seeing a little bit of the gutsiness of Matt Jones playing with some pain.
Picked up 13 on the last play. We'll hand it off here to Devin Poole, number one, who's listed as the fourth team tailback. But Houston Nutt telling us earlier in the week that he had had an outstanding week of practice. Expected him to play a lot today. Just a footnote. Remember we said talked about Matt Jones setting the quarterback rushing record. He needed 55 yards to surpass John Bond. Well, he lost 9 on a sack in the first half. That put him back at 54. So John Bond, watching him start from Mississippi, you still hold the record. You got it back.
I can stop erasing that on the when we show the graphic. He still holds it.
And we've tried to find where the injury, the groin injury to Matt Jones, occurred. This might be it.
Yeah, it's really hard to tell. McGlover able to wrap him up there, and certainly wherever he did it, I mean, it's affected his play. You see him getting up pretty gingerly at the end of that play, but at this point, Matt Jones just has to kind of fight through that and do what he can do from the quarterback position. Again, this entire team feeds off of his energy and off of his ability to make big plays, not just their offense, but the defensive players as well.
Second down and 12. Jones with good protection. He's got a man open. It's Harris. Stephen Harris, number 84, strolls in for a 61-yard score. They went at Kevin Hobbs, number 49, and Kevin Hobbs was beaten.
Kevin Hobbs and Montavis Pitts are splitting time at this cornerback position. A beautiful double move by Stephen Harris, and then a nice throw by Matt Jones. Harris actually had to wait a little bit for the ball, and Hobbs went for the interception but missed. And Arkansas right back in it with a score on their first second half possession.
Chris Balcero with the extra point is up, and it is good.
It's good. It's Auburn 30, Arkansas 14.
Stephen Harris, a 61-yard catch for the TD. 12:48 remaining in the third. 30-14. This crowd of 87,000 somewhat stunned now as Arkansas has scored back-to-back touchdowns. End of the first half, beginning of the second. This one, 74 yards, 5 plays, took 212. And Stephen Harris with the longest reception of his career.
And now the big goal for Arkansas. Let's get Cody Bliss into the game. Let's see if we can make Auburn punt the football.
Which they have yet to do. Here's a bobble picked up by Cadillac Williams. And he's loose. Out to the 30-yard line. Let's revisit this touchdown. There is a flag down.
Well, this is quarter coverage, which means these four guys are responsible for anybody that comes deep in their area. Here's Stephen Harris, and when he makes his double move, Hobbs is going to kind of squat on the route. And when he did that, Harris was able to run by him. I mean, there's only one guy in that area that can play defense, and that's Hobbs, and he didn't play it very well there.
Face mask call, 5-yard version of the face mask. So football moved out just across the 35-yard line. Houston Nutt's team. I ran into Keith Jackson at halftime, who's a part of the radio broadcast for the Arkansas Razorbacks. His son, Keith Jr., plays for Arkansas. He said, don't forget, we're a come-from-behind team.
Mm-hmm.
First down. Here's Campbell. Aroma Shadir. Out to the 41-yard line. And let's get more on Stephen Harris from Tracy Wolfson.
Thanks, Vern. Stephen Harris is a busy guy. He has school, football, and a wife and two kids to take care of, so you can imagine what his typical day is like. At 7 o'clock, he wakes up his kids, Kayla, who's 2, CJ's 11 months. He changes diapers, gets them dressed, and makes them breakfast. 9 o'clock, takes the kids to daycare, then heads off to class. 9:30 to 12:30, he has class. He fits in lunch, off to football practice, and meetings from 7:30 to 9. He finally gets to bed around 11 o'clock. You can imagine what a day he's had, and I thought we were busy.
Here's Campbell, quick opener, right side. Williams out to the 50-yard line. That'll be a first down. It's Ronnie Brown instead. number 23 instead of 24.
You know, just to follow up on that, I mean, time management is a huge thing for all student athletes. I mean, you've got to learn how to budget your time. When you go to college and you're on your own, you've got to learn how to manage when you have to stay in and study, you know, when you've got to prepare for football, when you can go out socially. Boy, this guy, he says, I try to maximize every waking minute that I have, and he's doing a great job of it.
Here's a first down and 10. And a play fake. Campbell back, rolls out to his right, gets a nice block, goes deep, it's caught at the 26-yard line by Courtney Taylor. 24 yards. Jason Campbell, Courtney Taylor.
Well, coming into the ball game, Courtney Taylor was the leading receiver with 17 catches. That's his third of the ball game today. And a nice little changeup, moving Jason Campbell out of the pocket, getting him outside, buying a little more time until Taylor crossed the field for him.
Carnell Williams deep back in the eye. Jake Slaughter is the fullback on this first and 10 play. Williams tries to bounce it outside. He's caught and dropped.
First tackle behind the line of scrimmage the entire game for the Arkansas defense. You know, they play with a lot of guys up around there. It's an eight-man front type of defense. And that is the first time that they've been able to get penetration and knock down somebody in a blue jersey behind the line of scrimmage. Desmond Sims, a backup linebacker in there to make the play.
Loss of two, second and 12. Campbell will go from the spread formation.
Middle of the field, a vulnerable spot right here for the Arkansas defense.
Campbell screen pass, and it's incomplete. Intended for Carnell Williams. It's gotten very, very quiet before this sellout crowd. You see predominant color is orange over in that corner. As we pan from right to left, there's a section of Razorback fans. But this Auburn team jumped out to a 30-0 lead right before the half. Matt Jones led Razorbacks back. They got one then, one to open this quarter.
And a huge play right here. Third down and 11. Arkansas needs a stop. Not a gimme field goal by any stretch of the imagination from right here if they can hold.
Blitz. Good blitz pickup by Williams. The pass is caught. Anthony Mix.
He fumbled the ball, though. Ripped out. It was caught. It was a first down, and it was ripped out on the way to the ground.
Arkansas ball. Lorenzo Robinson with the tackle. Mikel Vaughn with the recovery.
Well, here comes the blitz, all right? And Auburn is going to pick it up. So they do a good job of giving Jason Campbell time. Carnell Williams does a great job picking up the blitz. He hits his man. There's the catch. And at the end of the play, it's just ripped out by Lorenzo Robinson. And a huge defensive play for the Arkansas Razorbacks. Nice hit by Lorenzo Robinson right on the football.
Arkansas trails by 16, but they've got the ball.
The Home Depot SEC on CBS is sponsored by DiGiorno, Wrangler, Aflac, and by Sonic.
Welcome back to Jordan-Hare. Arkansas trail Florida 2 weeks ago, 35-7. Got within 38-30 in that game when Matt Jones was intercepted by Channing Crowder.
What were you saying about this place being quiet? It's picked up a little bit.
Yeah, there was some cheerleading going on by the blue-clad Auburn Tigers, and now a flag is dropped.
And I attribute that penalty 100% to the crowd here at Jordan-Hare.
Foul is a dead ball. False point. Number 74 on offense. Penalty is 5 yards from the previous spot.
The left guard, Stephen Parker, crowd noise up, hard to hear. Watch right here. Early movement. Back him up five more.
This is the least penalized team in the SEC. That was the seventh penalty against Arkansas in this game.
Very important now for Matt Jones to be smart with the football.
Hands it off to Dedrick Poole. Henry Cool scoots out across the 15-yard line.
Nice run.
Yes, it was.
Nice run on first down.
And Poole is hurt. Five-ten junior from Little Rock Central. And so the medical staff out quickly.
I'll never forget the game here 2 years ago as we take a look at the replay of Poole. Looked like he hurt himself on his way down to the ground. Looks like he's holding his right hamstring. And that could be a tough loss because Poole was giving him a little bit of a spark running the football. I mentioned 2 years ago, Arkansas came in here and Fred Talley was their feature back. And they did what was most people thought would be unimaginable. Here in Auburn, ran for 426 yards against the Auburn defense in a 38-17 win. Fred Talley had 241 of those yards. Matt Jones had a big 70-yard touchdown. It was like a track meet running the football. Not having the same kind of success running it against the 2004 defensive version of the Auburn Tigers.
Pull out to Corey Birmingham is back in. Poole did pick up 10 on that first down burst. It's second down and 5. Handed off to Birmingham. He goes left. 1 yard.
Number 32,
Antarius Williams, number 31, with a tackle.
Stop made by number 31, Antarius Williams.
Now Matt Jones continues valiantly on with a pull groin. We believe it happened when he was sacked.
Well, the problem is, like in a play like this, perfect example, it's third down and 5. Matt Jones needs to be able to scramble and run just as much as he can throw the football on a play like this. Can he do it now with the injury?
Four-man rush. Jones darts right. Pulls up. Did he get it? Yes, he did.
Completion,
but he's short of the first down.
Yeah. Completion but short. Tough throw on the run. Travis Williams providing the pressure on Matt Jones, but you can just see he is not the same Matt Jones that we're used to seeing. I think we got an illegal substitution penalty or participation penalty on Auburn. They might have had 12 guys on the field for that defensive third down play.
Josh Thompson hurries off, number 97. Here's Doyle Jackson.
Foul was illegal participation by the defense. 12 men on the field. Penalty is 15 yards from the previous spot, and the yardage results in the first down.
See, they're trying to substitute, so you see guys coming on, guys coming off, and they weren't able to get everybody off. Well, they're getting those guys off. They must still have too many guys out there.
On first down, Birmingham tries to go left. He's hit behind the driven down by Stanley McClover and Kevin Sears.
And again,
Sears, number 40.
You cannot run east and west against this defense. And DeCorey Birmingham needs to have that figured out by now. The only way to attack this defense is to get your shoulders turned north and south and try to find a crease. You can't outrun them to the sideline. And those first down runs for no gain really hurt the Arkansas cause.
Tracy Wolfson reports that Dedrick Poole is out for the remainder of the game with a pulled hamstring, right leg. Out of the spread, Kyle Roper snaps it back. They hand it off to Birmingham. He's dancing. He's doing a Fred Astaire behind the line. And as you said, that's not going to get it done.
Now that's the first time Auburn has really defended that play well. That little misdirection draw hurt them in the first half some, and it's the same running play that Tennessee used with some success a few weeks ago in Knoxville. Start the action one way and bring the draw back the other way. That time Auburn was ready for it.
Birmingham is out, third and 14. Darius Howard is on as the running back now. Three wide receivers split left. Hicks, the tight end, is tight right. This is Washington in motion. Again, a four-man rush. McClever coming. Jones drills it. Incomplete. Boy, again, that tough throw.
Yeah. You know, the fans are excited here for Auburn. The defense excited with the stop. If you're Arkansas, hey, it's okay. We don't have to score every possession here in the third quarter. We've got ourselves back within striking distance. We need a good punt and good coverage here. And again, see if we can stop the Auburn offense.
Jacob Skinner on the punt on 4th and 14, his third punt of this ball game. Carnell Williams at the 30.
Carnell had a 50-yard return last week against Louisiana Tech. They're first in the SEC in punt returns.
Oh, poor punt. Side of the foot. Now, that wasn't a poor punt. That was an awful punt.
Awful is a good word for it.
Skinner's not having a great year. He's averaging 37. Well, that one was 26 yards shy of his average. 7:19, third quarter. On this nearly perfect Saturday afternoon in October, we welcome you back to Jordan-Hare Stadium on the campus of Auburn University. Auburn scored the first five times it had the ball. They jumped out to a 30-0 lead. Arkansas fought back with a touchdown before the halftime break and to open the third quarter. It's 30-14 right now.
Best starting field position for Auburn out of the timeout. I would expect to see them take a shot at something down the field soon.
There's Cadillac Williams, who is belted as he gets back to the line of scrimmage. He and Ronnie Brown sharing the load in the tailback position.
Well, again, they both are outstanding runners. Ronnie Brown showing the versatility, being able to play fullback also. Williams with a few better numbers running it in the first half. Brown, a dangerous receiver coming into the game, the second leading receiver. Both guys scored a touchdown in that first half. And West Coast offense changed passing game, and it still starts and ends with the running game with those two tailbacks.
Second down 10, no gain for Williams. They bunch up to the right side now. And here's Williams. Down to the 43-yard line. What have they accomplished thus far? Ronnie Brown, 41 yards on 9 carries, and Carnell Williams, 63 yards on 13.
And another critical third down play for this Arkansas defense. You know that the last time Arkansas had the ball, the two worst things that could have happened, number one, a turnover, number two, a shanked punt, because field position in Auburn's favor right here on this third down play.
Third and 10. Stunts by the Arkansas defense. Here comes Huckabee. Campbell pulls up, finds a man. That should be enough for the first down. Let's see what the spot is. It's a left foot spot at the 33-yard line. Looks like he got 11. He needed only 10.
A nice job by Jason Campbell feeling the rush. You know, what you want a quarterback to do is see the field and feel the rush. Step up in the pocket. Obamanu, a little hook route, and Jason Campbell able to step up and find a throwing lane and make the nice throw for the first down.
And Campbell continues his torrid ways, throwing the football, first and 10. They bunch up on the right side, now the change. Whoops. And it's Williams following Brown's block to the 30-yard line. 30-14 here. And looks like an altercation might have broken out. Quickly separated. It'll be second down. John Jackson, number 5, second down and 8.
One of the things that you can see a big difference in the Arkansas defense here in the second half, I don't know how you correct this in the locker room unless you do some drills, is they're tackling much better. They had 15 missed tackles in the first half, 0 so far in the second half. A much better job of wrapping up the Auburn backs and receivers.
And remember, Houston Nutt said to Tracy Wolfson as they went to the halftime, that's one of the things he was concerned about. Now here's Williams, and a fine effort defensively by Arkansas. Now let's go back to New York and check in once again with Tim Brendo.
All right, Vern, they discovered another Alabama running back, Kenneth Darby, 26 rushes, 171 yards, here on the shovel pass from Spencer Pennington. Alabama up on Southern Mississippi. A Southern Miss loss would leave only two flies in the ointment, Utah and Boise State.
They could have a meeting.
Yeah.
A convention of flies. Third down. Third and eight. Jason Campbell. Williams is the running back.
Blitz coming.
Jackson coming. Campbell, little pressure from behind. Caught Mix at the 19-yard line. Anthony Mix in front of Lorenzo Robinson. And again, a third down conversion. They got 11 when they needed 10.
Well, when you blitz, you take the risk of playing man-to-man coverage. Watch Jason Campbell. Arkansas is going to bring more guys than everybody can get picked up. But he does a nice job of just stepping up inside the block of Carnell Williams and finding a throwing lane, buying a little extra time just by a little move of the feet. Good pocket presence that time by Jason Campbell.
How about this? A career high, 278 on 16 of 18 thus far. First and 10 at the 19. Hard to imagine that coming into this year, Jason Campbell had only 5 games in which he had thrown for 200 or more yards. He's just having a terrific final season. 30-14, 3:16 to go, third quarter. Auburn Tigers use a timeout. Now back at the line of scrimmage with a first down and 10 at the 19 with a 30-14 lead. High formation behind Jason Campbell, 16 of 18 thus far. Goes deep in the end zone. Obamanu, goes down! Ben Obamanu! He had 2 grabs for TDs last week against Louisiana Tech. He gets one from Campbell here.
Both catches last week of the acrobatic sort. This one, another one. Slightly underthrown pass, and he went up and fought himself for the football. His 6th touchdown catch on the season to lead the Tigers.
And Auburn will go for 2. If you were with us in the first half, you remember that John Vaughn missed an extra point, ending a streak of 209 consecutive extra points made by the Auburn Tigers. Here's Campbell back. He's got a man wide open. That's 2. That's 2 for 2. Ben Obamanu, 19-yard catch.
Well, as a blitz, he got 6. They went back to him on a 2-point conversion. He got 2. Jason Campbell throwing it great.
...38-14, Ben Obamanu from 19 yards out off the arm of Jason Campbell. And that is, Todd mentioned, his 6th touchdown reception this year. 2 came last week. Philip Yost to kick off for the undefeated Auburn Tigers. And here is Cedric Washington, chases it down, will take a knee and comes out to the 20-yard line.
As we go back to the touchdown, the more comfortable a quarterback gets, the wider his vision becomes. Now, he's going to see the corner blitz coming here, which means his receiver has just got to beat this defender coming over. But because Jason Campbell is comfortable in this game, he sees it, he feels it, he doesn't panic, and he makes a nice throw to the corner of the end zone for the touchdown. And then they come right back to Obamanu for the 2-point conversion. Jason Campbell averaging 17 and a half yards per completion, and he hasn't missed very many. 2, right?
Yes. Obamanu gets a little stretch. Here's Matt Jones. Play fake. Lobs it out. It's caught by his tight end. This is Mason Templeton. Only his 3rd catch of the year. Well, how opportune is this? This week's Scholar Athlete presented by Red Lobster. Ben Obamanu, a junior, has posted a grade point average of 3.38, business finance major, and he's a member of the SEC Academic Honor Roll. Red Lobster's commitment to the investment of our future is shown today by donating $1,000 to Auburn's General Scholarship Fund. Draw play, Birmingham. Darts left. Tackles, he gets near the 30. That might be enough for a first down.
You know, just going back to Ben Obamanu a little bit, I think he is probably one of the most highly respected guys on this Auburn football team. He was the guy last year in the game here against Ole Miss where he dropped a sure touchdown with about 30 seconds left in the game that would have given them a win over Eli Manning and Ole Miss. He had a great game that game, 6 catches for 150 yards, but he dropped that one, and he showed up in the media room right after the game and faced the media like a man and earned the immediate respect of all his teammates.
Here's the pass out left to Stephen Harris. Well, let's take a look at those two plays last year. Ben Obamanu from Jason Campbell.
He caught one touchdown earlier in the game. Again, 6 catches for 150 yards, but this is the one that all the Auburn fans, the one that got away with 30 seconds left in the game. But Ben Obamanu, I'll tell you what, and it's great to see a kid overcome something like that, come back, and have a big year this year like he's having for the Auburn Tigers.
Second down and 2 after that last gain of 8. Here's the handoff left side, Howard. And it's going to be a first down, Arkansas, out near the 43.
You know, I want to go back to little things, hidden yardage, things that get lost in the course of a football game. Arkansas comes out, they score right away in the second half. They're getting a little bit of momentum back in the game. They get the turnover. They have to punt the football, and that short punt by Jacob Skinner really hurt them because now Auburn is on their side of the 50-yard line. They can attack the end zone, and they're able to put one more score on the board. I don't know if Arkansas would have stopped them or not, but the short field makes it even tougher.
Hogs did get a first down and 10. Stephen Harris. Here's a play fake. Matt Jones, he wants to find Harris. Drills it. Diving try incomplete for Stephen Harris. Now, Tracy, giving you an update on Stephen Harris. His wife, Winter, they are the parents of 2 children. Really admirable. Stephen Harris already has achieved 1 degree, that in computer information systems. And he's working toward a 2nd degree in business administration. Worthy of our respect.
Yeah. He actually moved during the off week also from the split end position to the flanker position to make room for Marcus Monk. So he's a guy who's able to play both sides.
This is Birmingham.
Trying that dance step again.
Yep.
You just, there's no time to hesitate against this Auburn defense. When we talked to Gene Chizik, the defensive coordinator for Auburn, I asked him, is this defense faster than last year's defense? They're obviously small. He said, I don't know if we're actually faster just in pure speed, but we're playing at a faster rate of speed. And he thought a big reason for that is this is the 3rd year that these players have been exposed to the defensive system. And because of their greater knowledge, they're able to play at a faster rate.
Now with Gene Chizik standing in the middle. It's 3rd down. Here's Jones. McClever chasing him again, and McClever's presence might have resulted in a pass that was short.
Well, and even more so, Matt Jones is playing on one leg. I mean, he's playing on one leg, and he's getting nothing on some of these throws because he's just not able to step into them with that groin injury. McClever was there for sure, but Jones is not himself right now either.
Jeremy Davis.
That's going to bring on Jacob Skinner, who had a 14-yard punt last time out. 4th and 11. Cadillac Williams inside the 20. This one, line drive. Williams, a lot of room to return. Gets a block from Junior Rosegreen. There's a stiff arm, and he's out of bounds up near the 30-yard line. The tackle made by Jeremy Davis. 38-yard punt, 8 on the return, Thursday on Survivor. It's a wet and wild challenge. You'll have to see to believe. Don't miss TV's most watched reality show, Survivor Vanuatu, Thursday on CBS, America's most watched network. 22 seconds to go before the break. 38-14, Auburn. They've got the ball at their own 29, and Ronnie Brown is the running back. He gets the handle. Nice spin. Jed Huckabee, though, a nice job. This may be too nice a job. Might have grabbed the face mask.
Brought down by number 15,
There's a 5-yard incidental face mask, number 15 on the defense. 5 yards from the end of the run, following the first down.
Well, the difference on the 5 and the 15 is, did he use the hold of the face mask to help make the tackle? Huckabee did a nice job of holding his position, fighting off the block of Cooper Wallace, and you see it. The hand was on the face mask and came right off. That's a good 5-yard call, not 15.
Jeb Huckabee, whose father Ronnie is the defensive coordinator at Harding College in Searcy, Arkansas. And one of the leaders, having moved from linebacker to defensive end last year. One of the outstanding players for the University of Arkansas. We have reached the end of three. The score, 38-14, Auburn. We'll return to Jordan-Hare Stadium right after these messages. And a word from your local station.
Cadillac grills, Cadillac mills. Check out the oil my Cadillac spills. Matter of fact, candy paint Cadillac kills. So check out the oil my Cadillac fills.
You know, I knew if I stayed at this for long enough, they'd finally get my kind of music going.
Yeah.
We begin the fourth quarter, Auburn 38, Arkansas 14 from Jordan-Hare Stadium. And Jason Campbell, who has had a sensational day, will hand it off. And here's Ronnie Brown up the middle. We began the fourth for Lundquist, Todd Blackledge, Tracy Wolfson. Al Borges, we've talked a lot about him today. He said one reason this has all worked, him coming in, is that Hugh Knoll, last year's offensive coordinator, has gone back to his job as the offensive line coach.
And I really think we've got to highlight this offensive line, because we've talked about Jason Campbell. He's having a career day. We've talked about Carnell Williams and Ronnie Brown, but this offensive line has done a great job. Tommy Tuberville thinks it's the best offensive line since he's been here. And Hugh Knoll, I know my dad was a former offensive line coach. It's tough to coach all five positions and be a coordinator, and he's much more comfortable, I think, back coaching those big guys up front, and it really shows with this Auburn offense this year.
Ronnie Brown with a carry on second, first down, and Kevin Woods, number three, made the tackle.
You know, we hardly ever get to say the names of offensive linemen unless they are called for a penalty, but we've highlighted Marcus McNeil already today, but Ben Grubbs, the left guard, Jeremy Engel, the center. Danny Lindsay was the starting center last year, has moved to right guard where he's been a more productive player. And Troy Reddick, the starter at right tackle. That group has really played well this season.
Injured player for the Razorbacks is Marcus Whitmore, number 17. And while they tend to his needs, time has been called. 14-10 to go, 38-14, Auburn.
Now it's time for the Block of the Day, presented by Earthlink.
One of the things that we've seen so far this season with Auburn is the versatility of Ronnie Brown. He can play tailback, he can also line up as a wide receiver, and he's become a very good blocker. Here we see him leading the way for tailback Carnell Williams for a big run for Carnell. This time he's lined up in the slot again as a wide receiver. Watch him slip inside and lead on the draw play to Carnell Williams. We know Ronnie Brown can run. We know he can catch the football. Today we're seeing him block with extreme effectiveness in the Auburn offense. 113 yards rushing in the first half for Auburn. Earthlink Block of the Day belongs to Ronnie Brown.
For more on Earthlink's Block of the Day, log on to cbssportsline.com/earthlink.
Second and Marcus Whitmore, the injured Razorback, assisted off the field, number 17. And a second down and 5 now for Jason Campbell. We mentioned Hugh Knoll, last year's offensive coordinator, back as the offensive line coach at Auburn. Second down, 5. Silas Daniels, they hand it off instead. Cadillac Williams to the 50-yard line. That may be enough for another first down.
You know, it's interesting. We talked to Eddie Grand, the running back coach, yesterday for Auburn, and he kind of pulled us in his office and said, you know, I think that Carnell had a little different bounce in his step this week, a little different look in his eyes. I expect him to run real well today. And there's Eddie right there with the sunglasses on his hat, and they are running the football well. Eddie coaches these guys hard. He's been around Ronnie Brown and Carnell Williams for a long time and knows him pretty well.
And he showed me something I've never seen before yesterday in the coach's office. A stuffed turkey, and not with Thanksgiving stuffing.
Yeah,
this one was mounted Here's Brown going left to the 41-yard line. Eddie Grant is a huge turkey hunter. And I said, when's the season? He says, March 15th, May 1st. I'm out of here. Now, you told me that, man, I'm learning more from.
Well, I've never been turkey hunting. I just know some guys that are into it. And once you have done it, you kind of get hooked. And he's one of those guys that's hooked on turkey hunting.
Do you have an unquenchable desire to try that?
No, I don't. I like to eat turkey.
True.
But I have no desire to go out and hunt for one or try to gobble one in or do any whatever it is they do out there.
You and I are.
I'll eat them with the best of them.
I understand that. Here's Brown to the 38-yard line. Sam Olajuwon, I beg your pardon. And a lot of injuries for the Razorbacks today. Let's get more from Tracy Wilson. Trace?
That is right. The injuries are piling up for Arkansas. Marcus Whitmore, who you just saw, was assisted off the field. He has a left knee injury. He is done for the game. We also told you earlier that tailback Derek Poole is out for the game with a hamstring injury. And Arkansas quarterback Matt Jones, he's suffering from a groin injury. He is definitely hurting, but he is toughing it out there.
Yes, he is, Trace. Third and one here for the Auburn Tigers. Ronnie Brown, deep back in the eye. Jake Slaughter is the fullback.
The bad news for Arkansas on top of that is it's not going to get any easier from here. They go home next week to play Georgia, who is coming off a big win today at home against Vanderbilt.
Now mark that down. That was Jake Slaughter's first carry of the year. And might not get another.
No.
Houston Nutt's team, fourth and one.
Hey, look who's coming in the game.
Cody Bliss.
Start the presses. He gets to put his uniform in the washing machine after all.
Looks like he's had a tough day so far. Cody Bliss, first punt. Averaging 41.4 for the year. And this will be the old pooch kick.
Well, this is a sportsmanship call on Tommy Tuberville's part, too. I mean, could understand if he would have gone for it here, but not trying to rub it in on Houston Nutt at this point.
Time call by Auburn. That's their second. They have one left. Actually, Houston Nutt and Tommy Tuberville were co-coaches on the staff of Arkansas State for 3 weeks in 1984.
The Home Depot SEC on CBS is sponsored by Allstate, Ballpark Franks, The Home Depot, and by Pontiac.
Gorgeous mid-October Saturday afternoon, 10:48 to go. Auburn leading 38-14. And after taking the timeout on fourth down and two and having sent Cody Bliss on, now Tommy Tuberville has Auburn back on the field. I can't wait for your diagnosis of this one. Fourth and two.
That's draw a penalty.
Okay.
I still think they'll run a play.
Do you? Okay. Maybe take a 5-yarder. Yeah.
Well, good for him.
Yeah, I agree. Although I don't know that they needed a timeout to make that decision.
No.
So now Cody Bliss is back on. Well, we mentioned that Houston Nutt and Tommy Tuberville, they were on the staff with Larry Lacewell, who was kind of a guru for Tom Tuberville. Houston Nutt was their coaching quarterbacks. Tommy Tuberville, this is in the spring of 84, said, I went on a recruiting trip. I'd met Houston Nutt. I came back. He went to Oklahoma State. Was on the staff of Pat Jones. So they were colleagues for 3 weeks. So now Cody Bliss on the punt on fourth and six. DeCorey Birmingham is back to return the punt if it is returnable. This would bounce into the end zone and come out to the 20.
A 44-yard kick for Cody Bliss. Arkansas.
And let's go down now to Tracy Wolfson for the SEC moment presented by Sonic.
Vern, today is a career achievement moment for former Auburn defensive tackle and current Arkansas coach Tracy Rocker. A two-time All-America with the Tigers, Rocker won both the Outland and Lombardi trophies in 1988. He was honored today in a pregame ceremony recognizing his election into the College Football Hall of Fame. He will be officially inducted later this year in New York, the 10th Auburn Tiger to receive that honor. And guys, this is Rocker's first appearance here at Jordan-Hare Stadium since his senior season.
And he got quite an ovation ceremonies before the game. Here's the pitch out to Cedric Washington. Tracy Rocker. I got a chance to watch him play here at Auburn. He was very, very special.
You know, he carries so much respect with the guys he's coaching. I mean, they know that he's been there, that he's done it, and really love playing for the guys.
Got a nice walk up on College Avenue with all the stars in various sports here at Auburn. And Tracy Rocker has his star. Here's Matt Jones being chased, heading right, lets it go. Incomplete. 9:54 to go in this one. Let's go back to the studio for a Pontiac game-changing performance. Here's Tim.
All right, Vern. Texas trying to put it away against Missouri. It's amazing how easy it is for Cedric Benson when the defenders aren't from Oklahoma. Huh? 14 yards. He has 137 yards rushing on the day, and they're up two touchdowns.
All right, Tim. 38-14 here with 9:53 to go. Matt Jones out of the spread. Third and seven. And that one is over the head of, he can't plant at all.
No.
All arm.
And he knows he probably can't get a first down running it, so he's just staying in the pocket and trying to get the ball out there. And not having a lot of success right now. Plus Auburn knowing that the running game is not going to hurt him.
Well, Jeremy Davis is punting for the second time now. A little angry at Jacob Skinner, who shanked that one 14 yards. So Jeremy Davis on for his second punt. And the fair catch called by Cadillac Williams at the 34-yard line. 42-yard punt for Jeremy Davis, number 40.
And we talked about how important this game was for Auburn. Making a statement in the SEC West for sure today.
They're up 38-14, 9:37 to go.
That one's in your iPod too, isn't it? That
yes.
Song. When you go out for your walks on Saturday morning with your starting lineups.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I walk and talk and listen to that.
Yeah.
Here's the handoff. This is Carl Stewart, number 32.
Number 32.
Yeah, let's check the CBS Sports Line stat of the game. We'll go back to the keys to the game.
Well, for Arkansas, they did protect the football, so that was a yes. They did not do a good job of eliminating the big plays. They gave a couple easy touchdowns, and they weren't able to get the game to the fourth quarter with a manageable score. That was the key thing, getting there. What did Auburn have to do? Swarm Matt Jones. They did that. It was made a little bit easier with his groin injury. Jason Campbell obviously stayed very hot, and the special teams, they had the missed extra point, but pretty solid in field position all day.
Get complete game stats at CBSSportsline.com. And here's Carl Stewart as they work on the clock. Jason Campbell, 297 yards throwing. He has never had a 300-yard game in his career at Auburn.
Well, normally with an Auburn football team, if the quarterback throws for 300 or more, they're playing from behind, and they're probably losing the game. So that's not that big a deal, but he has played a beautiful game today. And how important is this game for Auburn? Obviously, to continue their quest for bigger things, championship-type things down the road, but in the SEC West, this will give them a two-game lead over everyone in the SEC West except for Ole Miss. Ole Miss coming in today has only lost one. They play tonight at home against Tennessee.
Third down and 7. Time permitting, the TIAA Kreft College Football Today Show. And Carl Stewart gets the handoff as they keep it on the ground, and they will give up the ball. Well, next week, our little traveling troop will be going back to Knoxville next Saturday, 3:30 Eastern Time. Alabama against Tennessee. There are a few subplots to that encounter.
You wouldn't call that a friendly rivalry?
Ooh, no. And it all begins with the TIAA Kreft College Football Today Show. 4th and 6 here, and Cody Bliss is saying, gosh, guys, again?
Not only may he have to wash his uniform, he may have to take a shower after the game, too.
And here is DeCorey Birmingham at the 27-yard line. He's got a chance to return it, but there's a flag down. And Birmingham going right. Ronnie Brown is deep. But I believe this one is going to come back. There's a flag back at the 28.
35-yard punt.
How about Ronnie Brown making the tackle?
Yeah.
I mean, this is the one area in special teams, even though they gave up the big return, they have 8 of their starters on their punt team. That's the most starters they have on any special teams unit. Tommy Tupperville, a big believer in special teams, and the punt team the most important in his mind, because 2 big plays that can affect field position, a block kick or a big return. And so he has all those starting guys in there. Ronnie Brown here in the fourth quarter making a tackle on the return.
Foul is an illegal block in the back by number 16 during the return. Penalty is 10 yards from the spot of the foul, followed by the first down.
Materrell Richardson is guilty of the foul. That wipes out a 51-yard return of that 35-yard punt.
We've seen a little bit of everything from Ronnie Brown. Running it, catching it, blocking, and now tackling.
And Matt Jones is through for the day. He's given way to Robert Johnson, number 18. Robert Johnson playing now in only his 3rd game this year. Previous appearances against New Mexico State and Louisiana Monroe. Matt Jones, and just a footnote, remember we said he had set a new career rushing record for quarterbacks. He needed 55 yards. He was at 63. Well, he was sacked, and that was the play on which we think he was injured. Sacked for a loss of 9. In college football, that goes against your rushing totals. So, at least for another week, John Bond of Mississippi State still holds the career quarterback rushing total. Here's Robert Johnson being chased by McGovern. Out of bounds. And a moment ago, the conversation on the bench with Matt Jones and Houston Nutt.
Well, those two have had some good moments together. I mean, Matt Jones has been a real warrior for Houston Nutt, and it's been a relationship that has evolved over the years. A real mutual respect, I think, with the two of them. And Matt Jones not able to get it done today, but he has had some wonderful moments for the Arkansas Razorbacks.
Robert Johnson for the year, 6 of 9 for 142 yards, 2 touchdowns, those in the 2 games in which he appeared. Goes right. Whoa. Carlos Rogers on Stephen Harris.
One of the interesting things about Robert Johnson and this Arkansas offense is that because of Matt Jones' shoulder problems, he doesn't throw on Thursdays. Robert Johnson, the backup quarterback, gets all the passing reps on a normal Thursday practice. So ready to come in, but that 3rd down play, not very effective.
Jeremy Davis on for his 3rd punt of this second half, and Carnell Cadillac Williams at the 40. Good one. Mm-hmm. Oh, really a good one. Williams all the way back at the 23. There's a flag. This one's going to come back. Cadillac Williams out to the 43-yard line.
There is a flag. A 55-yard punt.
Donnie Young, one of the 18 seniors on this team, is going to be judged guilty of this illegal block, number 10. Now, the normal punt returner for this Auburn team, here's the penalty being marked off by Doyle Jackson, and he'll confirm, I believe, that it was number 10, Donnie Young. Perhaps.
That was an illegal block in the back. During the return, number 10, penalty is 10 yards from the end of the foul, followed by the first down.
The point I was going to make is that Trey Smith is normally their punt returner. Trey Smith has played in only two games this year because of a shoulder injury, unavailable again today. That may be why Cadillac Williams is back there. Okay. 38-14, 5:53 to go. Let's take a look at the play of the game presented by Wrangler 5-Star Premium Denim. Here's Rob Bramlett of the Auburn Radio Network.
A two receiver bunch set on the near side. On first down, toss it to Carnell, hand it off to Taylor, flip it back to Campbell. He's got a man open downfield to Robinson at the 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10. Goodbye! Touchdown! Oh my goodness! Campbell to Robinson. Touchdown, Tigers!
Wrangler five-star play of the game, 67 yards. That was the first touchdown. Five possessions and five scores for Auburn to open up a 30-0 lead. Ronnie Brown gets the handoff. And Ronnie Brown is on a rumble. Uses the shield from Upamanu and crosses the 50 and is down to the 46-yard line. A 41-yard gain. Vickell Vaughn makes the tackle.
Coming into the game, Ronnie Brown was averaging 8 yards per carry. This one here is not going to hurt that average at all. A little cutback against a tired Arkansas defense. You know, one of the things about rotating your backs and having Carnell Williams and Ronnie Brown is that you can keep your backs relatively fresh into the fourth quarter. They don't need it today. But in back-to-back weeks now, Ronnie Brown over the 100-yard mark.
And both over 50, and you know that they are undefeated now in 11 games when they both gain in excess of 50 yards. First down and 10. That one was good for 41. It puts Ronnie Brown over the 100-yard mark. This is Carl Stewart, the 32, down to the 43-yard line.
Number 32, Carl Stewart.
Mentioned when we came on the air that this Arkansas team playing with heavy hearts today, the entire Arkansas family. On Wednesday of this week, Barbara Broyles, wife for 59 years of Frank Broyles, the former head coach and athletic director, passed away after a 5-year battle with the insidious disease Alzheimer's. Barbara survived by her husband Frank back in Fayetteville. 6 children, 4 sons, 2 twin daughters, their spouses, and 19 grandchildren. And those of us who knew her will miss her sorely. Brandon Cox is on at quarterback. That was the reason for the applause, and it's picked off. And immediately here's Vickell Vaughn trying to get down the sidelines. He's hauled out of bounds by King Dunlap, number 77. But on Brandon Cox's first pass, Vickell Vaughn goes the other way.
Well, coming into the game, he completed 70% of his passes. He completed this one too, just to the wrong color jersey. Vickell Vaughn not giving up on the play, stayed in bounds. But how about the athleticism of King Dunlap? 6'8", 305 pounds. He just came into the game. That was his first play in the game as well. And he cut off the angle of Vickell Vaughn to the end zone.
Brandon Cox, who is 24 years of age and only a redshirt sophomore. Sat out 2002 and then redshirted last year, redshirt freshman, I beg your pardon. And on first down, here's Robert Johnson. Play fake, rolls right. Looks for Washington, finds him at the 10-yard line. Cuts inside, he's down to the 3. And a flag is thrown. Nope, there's a scramble, and who got it?
I think they're calling him down before the ball came out.
Will Herring ripped it out.
Ah! Take a look at the end. Washington fighting for yards. Herring trying to rip the ball out, and his knee was down before the ball came out.
So the ball at the three. Jason Campbell, career day, 297 yards. Two hit the ground. Kyle Dickerson is the deep back in the eye. First and goal, Johnson fires it, caught the fullback, Brandon Kennedy, number 47. 4-yard touchdown pass.
Well, I think you got to go for two here if you're Arkansas. It would make it a 16-point game if they can get the 2 points, which would be two touchdowns and two 2-point conversions. May not be feasible, but that's what your thinking is at this point.
And they will attempt to try for two. Birmingham and Robert Johnson in the backfield. 38-20 and the try for two forthcoming.
I mentioned the point about Robert Johnson getting a lot of reps on a couple days in practice when Matt Jones doesn't throw. So he's a little more prepared than most backup quarterbacks in college football because he gets a lot of work during the week.
That was Brandon Kennedy's first career touchdown. Here's the try for two into the corner. Well over the head of Marcus Monk. And so Houston Nutt's team still down by 18. 3 minutes and 39 seconds to go. Auburn by 18. .339 to go in this one. Auburn 38-20, about to go 7-0 for the year. Watched network.
Well, the Auburn hands team on the field. Ben Obamanu, Ronnie Brown, Carlos Rogers, Courtney Taylor, Carnell Williams, the lone deep back, expecting the onside kick attempt now from David Carlton.
And Balsero will kick it.
Oh,
the other kicker. That's a nifty little trick, but taken over the shoulder catch is made by Will Herring, number 35. And that gives us a chance to check in once again with Tim Brando.
Vern, Alabama's got a new running back for you guys to see, and I got some news for you. Kenneth Darby, 10-yard run. He had 197 on the day, two touchdowns. They beat Southern Miss, and you and Todd will be in Knoxville for Tennessee and Alabama next week. Archie Manning's going to come into the studio with Spencer and myself. We look forward to it. No love lost between those two, especially now.
That's well, you right. know, Kenneth Darby was sharing time with Ray Hudson earlier in the season. Hudson hurt last week in their ball game, their big win over Kentucky. And so now it's the Kenneth Darby show. Tim Castillo also playing some tailback for Alabama.
Number 32.
Under 3.5 to go. Well, BCS standings for the first time will be released on Monday. The poll comparison, the top 10 this week. Southern Cal, Oklahoma, Miami, Auburn, Purdue, Virginia, Florida State, the top seven, identical in both polls.
A couple of those teams unbeaten that will still be in action tonight. Virginia and Florida State play tonight, so one of those two teams will drop out. Purdue and Wisconsin play also, so one of those two teams will drop down out of the top ten.
Second down here, we'll talk a little bit more about Miami's victory over Louisville. 41-38. On Thursday night, second down and 5. And here's Carl Stewart breaking through. That'll be a first down. The clock will stop as they reset the chain with 2:40 to go. Todd, you know, obviously we're seeing Auburn live. We've not seen Miami live this year. But if you're a voter, do you tend to be more taken with a decisive victory like this or a 41-38 come from behind victory by Miami?
Well, I'm not a voter anymore. There was a point when I was an AP voter, and I would not move a team down if they won. And I don't think many voters will move Miami down. One thing you got to remember, the team that Miami played, Louisville, was undefeated, and they were a ranked opponent. So even though they had to come back and win, is a little different scenario than Auburn beating Arkansas, who came in with two losses. So Auburn was impressive, but in a lot of ways, Miami was impressive in the way they came back in that game last week as well.
Tommy Tumberville, we're at the 2-minute mark. And one other footnote before they release those BCS standings tomorrow.
It's our understanding, and we checked with our own guru, who we travel every week, Matthew Sein, that no two teams who've been ranked 1 and 2 since the BCS process began, no two teams who were ranked first and second in the first release of the standings have ever made it both to the championship game.
Yeah, there'll be a lot of people that when it comes out on Monday will say, oh, we should be higher, or this shouldn't be the case. And that first one is really just the beginning. And as we get into the month of November, that's when it gets interesting.
And I'm sure we're going to discuss some flies in some ointments right now. Let's go back to Tim.
All right, Vern. Well, Texas relinquishes a touchdown here to Brad Smith, and they miss the extra point. Can you believe that? It's 28-20. Texas still with the lead, still some time remaining in the fourth in Austin. Back to Vern.
Just no time for flies that time.
Yeah. Relinquish the touchdown.
Ooh.
Reminded me of the old Princeton defensive cheer.
Which
repel
one?
Them, repel them, make them relinquish the ball.
Here's Stewart down to the 40-yard line. Final 38 seconds.
And an Auburn first down at the Arkansas 40.
As this has been a very impressive Auburn victory.
Yes, sir.
521 yards in this ball game for the Tigers. 224 rushing, 297 passing. Matt Jones, valiant. Jason Campbell, brilliant. And the Auburn Tigers are going to go 7-0.
Next week they play Kentucky. Their schedule very fortunate for them. Then they go to Ole Miss. They're home against Georgia, and they finish up in the Iron Bowl at Tuscaloosa.
Ran out to a 30-0 lead. Arkansas came back. Scored just before halftime and to open the third quarter. Matt Jones injured groin in the second quarter. And the Auburn Tigers win it 38-20. And our player of the game, Jason Campbell, 17 of 19, 297. That's a career best. 3 touchdowns. And let's go down to Tracy Wolfson, who is with Jason Campbell.
Thanks, Vern. Jason, congratulations. A career day for you. A tremendous performance. How did you get it done?
Well, you know, our coaches did a great job preparing us all week. You know, they kept enforcing that we know we need to go out and continue to keep playing hard. And, you know, that's what's got us to this point. You know, my teammates did a great job playing today. You know, it was just a great team effort.
I have coach right here. Tommy, congratulations as well. What do you have to say about this kid?
Well, he keeps getting better every week. You know, the thing about Jason, he's gone through some tough times, but he's also learned from those tough times. I'm proud of him, proud of the whole team, but he really played well today, especially the first half.
7-0, still in the hunt for an SEC and national championship. What does this say about your squad?
You know, we just take it 1 week at a time. You know, we know that we can't go no further than this game. You know, you always got to prepare yourself for just one game a week. And, you know, as long as we just stay focused and, you know, keep the right attitude, we'll be all right.
How does it feel, Coach, to finally get that win over Arkansas? Tough times with them in the past.
Last time we played them here, it wasn't pretty. And we got it handed to us pretty good. Today we flipped the tables. But this, you know, good football team, we're getting better. And, you know, it really doesn't make any difference who this team plays every week. They just keep working hard and playing well, and I'm proud for them.
Thanks a lot, guys. Congratulations. Vern, back to you.
Matt Jones, gimpy leg, couldn't get it going today. 38-20, final score and final thoughts, Todd.
Well, I think that what they went through last year was difficult. I mean, it was hard for them to endure that, starting ranked so high and then fading so fast. But that experience and how they mishandled the hype and the publicity last year is helping this football team right now. This team is focused. They are taking it one game at a time, and they're getting better each game.
They are 7-0 in the 2004 season, and they have drawn a favorable schedule as they compete for the SEC West Championship and a spot. Here's the lineup tonight: Survivor Vanuatu, followed by Cold Case and 48 Hours Mystery. That's the lineup tonight on CBS. That'll wrap it up from Jordan-Hare. We're going to go watch him roll Toomer's Corner. For Tracy Wolfson and Todd Blackledge, I'm Vern Lundquist. We'll see you next week in Knoxville.